Hi, it's Kiffin Lobates here, and the reason why I'm lurking behind this laptop is because today I'm going to do a demonstration of my RFID plus blockchain invention, and I don't have a cameraman, so I can't get them to move around and actually handle this for me. So I've talked about this RFID authentication issue before, namely that the problem I have found with RFID tags is that they can only do two-way authentication, not one-way authentication. So the reason for that is that there are cards out there that allow you to have symmetric cryptographic keys in order to read data on them and write data to them. And that is useful for things like public transport, where you have a certain number of credits on your card, or for vending machine tags, where you can load them up with credit and then spend it at a vending machine. And there, the vending machine or the ticket barrier at the transport system has a reader that has that secret key, and it uses it to read the tag and then check that it's authentic. But cheap tags at the lower end of the spectrum are identified through their UID, or universal identifier, unique identifier. But the problem is that the UIDs are not unique. You can go on the black market and buy 10,000 blank My Fair Classic cards and write whatever UID you want to them, so you can clone tags. And that means that in, for example, supply chain, using an RFID tag to provide authenticity for goods just doesn't work. They are no better really than a QR code, other than the fact that you can scan them in the dark or through a container, say. But apart from that, an RFID tag is no more secure than a QR code or a barcode stamped on the side of the goods. And you're paying a lot more than you are for a QR code, of course. So what my invention does is it allows a standard tag, such as a My Fair Classic or a My Fair Plus, to provide one-way authentication. And I'm doing this with what is basically a one-time pad that is loaded onto the tag. And then a blockchain is used to publish the current key in use. And then with a reader, you can scan the tag, perform an authentication, and write that event back, and the next key is released. So it does have the downside that you can only, on a My Fair Classic, perform 16 authentications. If you have a bigger tag, or if the data structure was set up more in line with what this invention needs, then a 1K tag could provide more in the region of, say, 64 authentications, which I think would be plenty for any supply chain system. Plus, you can always reuse the tag. Anyway, I'm going to move around to the side here to show you what's going on. So what I have here is a key server running on a Ubuntu machine in the cloud, and it's connected to a blockchain, and it also takes incoming requests from my phone. So here's the authenticator, and what you can do is you can put a tag against the authenticator, and it sends off the ID to the key server, which then checks on the blockchain to see if that tag is registered, and if it is, it retrieves the current key in use. And then, well, this is going to be a little bit awkward. You can see this key has got, or rather this card has got 11 authentication attempts left, and if I hit the authenticate button, you can see it says the tag is authentic. And it's now burnt one of these one-time pad things. And here in the background, you can see that the use of that key has now been reported, and a new key is published from the database onto the blockchain. So this is a reader that could be being used by somebody in a shipping terminal or a freight company who has no connection to the goods that have actually been tagged by the manufacturer. So I'll do the authentication again. Of course, my phone goes off just at the wrong time, and there we go. So I put the tag against the reader, and it's not reading it. That is not very impressive, is it? Okay, there we go. It's managed to read the UID. It says there are 10 authentication attempts left, and I hit authenticate, and it says the tag is authentic. Now, if I take a fake tag that I have conveniently made over here, this is one which UID has been loaded onto the system, and there are actually 16 authentication attempts left, but this card doesn't contain the right data, so it's effectively a fake clone of the tag with this ID. If I put that against the reader, I should hasten to say here, I haven't cloned tags, I haven't bought any blank ones. Oh, there we go, it's been read. No, there we go. Now when I hit authenticate, it tells me the tag is not authentic, and that is correct. So this tag, if attached to some goods, would indicate that those goods are also not authentic. Anyway, I'll move back so you can see me. That's a demo of the system. That's how it works. It's quite simple, really, but like a lot of ideas, simple once you know what the idea behind the whole thing is. I hope you found that interesting. I'm looking for either RFID tag architecture designing companies or manufacturing companies who are interested to see if they would like to move forward with actually productizing this system. One of the advantages of using a blockchain for disseminating the keys is that you have this open decentralized system so that anybody can use it. And it should tie in nicely with the applications that blockchain has to supply chain. So you can use the supply chain to track the goods as they pass through different parties' hands, and you can use the tags to track the goods as well. So the fact that the tags are being tracked on the blockchain should have some nice synchronicity with the use of a blockchain for actual supply chain purposes. Anyway, I'll wrap it up now. I hope you found that interesting. Do get in touch if you want to hear more. Bye for now.